See, many of us, because of the storms, because of things that come against us, we end up saying, it's not working. It's not working. But I'm telling you, if you put this CD in your house, put it in your house, and let the Holy Spirit start speaking in your house, something begins to transform you. Something begins to happen in your house. Hallelujah. Like metal to a magnet, good things find you. You don't find it. It finds you. But we've been saying just negative things. We've been just murmuring and complaining and whining and crying and arguing, fussing, fighting, fretting, disobedient, rebellion, and stubborn. We've been backbiting, gossiping, criticizing, negative, filled with jealousy, envy, strife, and coveting. That's not going to get it for you. You got to turn that station to KYMS. And if you can't say nothing, you can do something. It is the vocabulary of Scripture. I don't know the Scripture. It's the vocabulary of sinus, then don't say anything else. And it's the vocabulary of sigh, just the lifting of your hands and waving your hands. It's a symbol and it's a sign. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, friend, just the lifting of your hands is a symbol and a sign that you win. When someone comes across the finish line, what do? The first thing they do is throw up their hands. Why? They're the winner. Hallelujah. They're the winner. When someone wins the battle and the referee is calling them, then he lifts up the hand. Why? Because it's a sign, it's a symbol that you have won. And when you're dancing, see, when people don't dance, they drag, they sag, they lag. And the devil is glad that you're dragging, sagging, lagging. You ain't got nothing, ain't gonna get nothing. You just like some, a big weight upon you. But when you start dancing, and the word dance, it don't mean that you got to know how to do the shimmy, shimmy, coco pop. It doesn't mean that you have to know how to do the jerk and all that. It doesn't mean, no, when God says dance, God says get your feet up off the ground. Just start walking on the devil. Start, come on somebody, give God a praise. Just start walking on the devil. It's a sign. It's a symbol. Now, you may not look happy, but when your feet don't fail me now, glory to God, you start dancing for the Lord. And the devil knows something different is taking place. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. See, I'm giving you the vocabulary. Mother Johnson, we're given the vocabulary of Scripture, the vocabulary of sign, the vocabulary of silence. We're giving you the vocabulary. Now, you can do that. You can do that. You can do it. Hallelujah. And watch things turn around. Watch God turn things around for you. Have you ever heard of an interception? In other words, they throw the ball to their team, but the other team intercepts it and carries it another way. The Holy Spirit has a way of intercepting that ball, turning whatever you're going through. He can turn it around for you. Hallelujah. Somebody ought to praise God with me. God can turn it around for you. God can turn it around for you. I said, God can turn it around for you. This is why we come to church, because we come to learn the language that can help us find our faith. Where is your faith? When you see people that are never praising God, they don't know where their faith is. You see, when you open up your mouth, it's a faith locator. It's going to tell you where your faith is. Jesus said to his disciples, where is your faith? And they said, because they were smothered with fear. They said, we're going to die. And Jesus said, nah, did I say that to you? No. Now, are you in Hebrews chapter 3? I know you probably thought I forgot, but I haven't. Hebrews chapter 3, verse 1. Hebrews chapter 3, verse 1. Because, see, Jesus is the author and the finisher of our faith. Is he not? He's the author and the finisher of authentic faith. And in John chapter 1, now we're going to look at Hebrews chapter 3, but I want to quote this for you. John chapter 1, verse 1, it says, in the beginning was the Word. That's Jesus. The word there is Logos. In the beginning was the Logos. That is a word. The Word of God personified. The Word of God in person. Jesus is the person of the Word. He is the Word itself. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God, and all things were made by Him. It's referred to Him as a Him. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. And then it says, and the Word became, listen, the Word put on some flesh. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Jesus is the Word of God. He's the author and the finisher of your faith. Everything that He says, we ought to say. This is what He says in Hebrews chapter 3, verse 1. Are you there? I'm feeling like Mr. Rogers. I'm getting in the neighborhood. I'm coming down your street, your boulevard. I'm hoping that you're home because I'm going to knock on your door. Glory to God. Praise the Lord. And you got to say what God is saying. It'll change your life. This is what He says in Hebrews chapter 3, verse 1. Wherefore, holy brethren, He's talking to holy brethren. He's talking to God's children. Wherefore, holy brethren, partakers of the heavenly calling. Ooh, ooh. That's enough to make somebody say, ooh, ooh. Because you may not ever get a call from the White House, but you will get a call from God's house. God has called you. You got a call from God? He says a heavenly calling. You got a call from heaven. And friend, you may not be saved, but God's calling you today. God's telling you, pick up your phone today. Don't ignore God or refuse God today. He says, wherefore, holy brethren, partakers of the heavenly calling. And then I love this name. He said, consider. Now, I just wish I had a lot of more time. But I'm hoping that you get this CD, because when he say consider, just that little word consider is a profound word. The word consider, it means to ponder. Six things it means to ponder. Number one, the word consider, when he says that you have a high calling or a heavenly calling, then he says, now consider. Why not just tell us the apostle and high priest? But he want you to consider. Why? Because the word consider carries these six connotations. Consider is to ponder. Do you know what it is to ponder, D? He says ponder. Then consider number two is pay attention to. Consider is to ponder, pay attention to. Consider number three, it is to think about. Consider, ponder, pay attention to, think about. Consider, ponder, pay attention to, think about. Then he says, look at, look at, look at. See, the scriptures tell us, looking unto Jesus, looking unto Jesus. What were the disciples looking at when they were in that boat and Jesus said, we're going to the other side? They were looking at the storm. They were looking at the water. They were looking at the waves. They spoke about those things. But the scriptures tell us to ponder. Say ponder three times. Ponder, ponder, ponder. Because the word consider means to ponder. Ponder, pay attention to, think about, look at, see. And here it is, the sixth word, say. You end with say. I'm telling you, your vocabulary is the faith finder. He says to consider, which is ponder, pay attention to, think about, look at, see, say. Say what? Say who He is. Now listen, say who He is. And then you combine that with who He is and I am His. Friends, so many of us, we just look at ourselves and we don't say who He is. See, we need to know more about the God we have our faith in, grow more in the God you have your faith in, give more in the God you have your faith in. So we need to consider. He said, consider what? Consider what? No, it's a consider Him. Consider is ponder, pay attention to, think about, look at, see, say who He is. Say who He is. He's the Most High God, the possessor of heaven and the earth. He's the deliverer of all of my enemies and my needs. Say who He is. He's the God that shall supply all my needs. When you look at your bills and your bills start talking to you, and listen, things talk to you. You look at your money and your money look funny and your money starts saying, you ain't got enough money to pay this, that, and the other. No, you look at Him and say who He is. You start saying who He is, not listening to your money, not listening to your bills. Oh, I don't know how we're going to, I just don't make enough money. I don't know what we're going to do. I don't know how we're going to make it. No, no, no. See, things talk to you and your vocabulary locate your faith. Where is your faith? Is your faith in your money or is your faith in your God? And so when you consider, ponder, pay attention to, think about, look at, see, and say who he is, and then say, I'm his. Glory to God. And see, if you are his, then it's not about what you have to pay for. My God supplies all you need. Why? Because you don't belong to yourself. You belong to your God. Hallelujah. You belong to your God, and your God is never broke. Your God is never empty. Your God will make a way where there is no way. Your God will open up the Red Sea for you. Your God will bring down the walls of Jericho for you. Your God will make a way where you say there is no way, but there is a way with God. God is God and God alone. And you can say who he is and then say, I am his. Glory to God. Say, I am his. Say, I am his. And then you say what he says, and then you say what he says, because what he says, say, I will say. Come on, say, I will say. See, it's not what you, listen, it's not what you see in the natural. You say, I don't see how this is going to work. I don't see. What did he say? See, faith can change facts. My God, somebody need to hear what I'm saying. Faith can change facts. If Jesus can turn the water, was that real water? That's a fact, it was water. But he changed that water into wine. Faith can change facts. The doctor's report, the doctor can say this, that, or the other, but God said in his word. And why did God say this? Because there are times that the doctors say you're going to die, and in Psalms 118, he says that you're not going to die, but say, I'm going to live and declare the mighty works of the Lord. Come on, who are you going to agree with? Your vocabulary finds your faith. Whatever he say, commit this today. Whatever he say, I will say. Go ahead. Whatever he say, I will say. One more time. Whatever he say, I will say. He said you're the head and not the tail. He said you are above and not beneath. He said that you are above. Whatever he say, commit this to your heart, my brothers and sisters. Whatever he say, I will say. Say, see, it's an act of your will. I will say. Whatever he say, I will say in representation, not substitution. If he's the Lord, Brandon, and if he say something, you don't say, well, it don't look that way, but this is what I'm going to say right here, because it doesn't look, no. Don't substitute him. Represent him. Commit yourself, whatever he say, I will say. Now, he's not telling you to fake something. See, faith is not faking it. He's not telling you to pretend. That would be lying. If God said it, shall he not do it? If God spoke it, God's going to bring it to pass.